So let's talk about data models. The data model, the structure in which a record is saved, is a file that can be exported and imported into the data model pane of either the Connect Designer or the Connect Data Mapper. The advantage of being able to do this is to be able to import a data model into both the designer and the data mapper simultaneously from different computers, so your designer can work on creating a template, while your data specialist can work on creating the data mapping configuration that goes with the data model. So let's say you have an existing data model that you want to import into Designer and be able to use the different fields in order to create your template. Importing a data model is super simple. All you need to do is to click on the Import button, navigate to the appropriate data model, and open the file. Now, opening a data model doesn't import any of the data attached to it. So basically, you only have the field names and the field types, but you don't actually have any of the data attached to it. So let's say you want to add a field onto the template. You can simply drag it as you would normally with a complete data mapping configuration. However, when you go into preview mode, you get nothing because there is no data attached. So let's design the rest of the template using the existing fields in the data model, and then we'll take a look at adding the actual data. So now that all the text scripts have been created, all of the variable data has been added to the template, when we go in preview mode, there really is nothing variable. It's all gone because all of the fields that are in the template have been attributed to the appropriate field in the data model. So what about getting actual data? Well, because we're using a data model, the best and kind of only way to get data attached to it with the proper field names is to open or create a data mapping configuration that is using the exact same data model. And it just so happens that I have one. So the data model for this data mapping configuration corresponds exactly to the one that we have in the template. It was created using the same data model. So when we come back to the template, all of the data is filled. Everything is functional. We see the date, we see the total that I put in the middle of the text, and the full address block, and that's fully functional. It would technically be possible to readjust the template if you import a data mapping configuration with different field names, but you would have to correct all the scripts individually for every single one of the fields that has a different name. So using data models will save you time and will save you a lot of headaches.